gambling causes a lot of problems.
Thanks.
All starts simple, but
it's become a need to gamble.
Everything is a chance.
But what gives people the confidence to put everything for a chance?
Maybe it's not money they're chasing for,
but feeling a high.
The spin of the wheel or roll of the dice can change a person's life forever.
Go from rags to riches?
Or the other way around.
We have to stop gambling in its tracks.
Gambling will lead you down the wrong path.
Did you know that?
Gamblers are more likely to have mental illnesses and abuse drugs.
60.8% of gamblers experience personality disorders.
It's estimated that 80% of the Canadian population have at least gambled once in their life.
Of all people with gambling addiction, 38% of them are drug addicts, 75% of them are alcoholics, and 60% are nicotine dependent.
41% of gamblers experience anxiety disorder.
It was a billion-dollar industry. They made $40 billion last year.
6 to 8 million people in America are compulsive gamblers.
Even with knowing all of this, gamblers can't stop.
The worst part is only 15% of gamblers face their problems.
It doesn't affect you.
Gambling affects everyone.
Even your loved ones.
It will affect my loved ones too.
So, me and my husband went gambling this one time. It was our honeymoon night. We thought we'd have some fun with all the guest money and our gifts. And once we went, we won real big. We won with like $200,000 once we got back. And after that, we decided to go back every year. Except we didn't go back every year. We went back every month. Soon, it lasted, the $200,000 lasted us about 4 years. We had 2 kids by then, 2 boys, and that's when my husband decided that we shouldn't go back. That we should spend more time and all our savings on our kids. But I just felt more appealed to go back, and I just wanted to go back. So this one night, I decided to leave. I left home with $4,000. Had to rent a bike to get back. I lost the keys. I bet the house away. And then once I told my husband, he decided to leave. Took our 2 kids and now I have divorce papers on the table. I don't know what to do now. I can't afford food, I can't afford an apartment to live in. I might even have to, like, my parents aren't taking me back. And, no, it's just, I'm done.